Hi everyone, welcome to the project of the week. So in this week, what we are going to build is an intelligent mobile phone holder. It's very common that, you know, we put our cell phones into silent mode and we search all our home. So we are going to build an intelligent mobile phone holder, as I said, which will indicate whether your cell phone is inside the holder or not through a LED indication. So I'll show you how to build this. So these are the components that what you need. You need a pair of batteries, a serial connector, a cell phone, glue with a cellophane tape, a red LED, and you need pair of IR sensor. So this is a pair of IR sensor. What I have done over here is I have cut down the legs of IR sensor to a shorter, so such that, you know, the positive one is bit lengthier and the negative is bit short. You can clearly see it over here. I also have 2-pin connector. This is a connector, and I have 3 2-pin patch cards. These are 3 2-pin patch cards. I have 1 D box and 2 small boxes. So let me show you how to construct this project. So take a small box and cover it with a paper so that it looks good. And this is a holder kind of stuff which I have made using a simple black color chart paper. It's a simple black color chart paper. So now I'm going to fix this over here and put my cell phone like this. So what I will do next is I will put glue to this. So once this is done, so I'm gonna fix it over here. And just make sure that this is firmly stick to the box. But now it is done. For our case, I will also put on tape, ensuring that this has firmly stuck. And you don't need glue anymore. Let me keep it aside. Let's take one more piece of tape and stick it. Now the holder is firmly stuck to the base board. So let me check this once again. So yes, it's holding the mobile phone. This is enough. So let me take my mobile phone, and I need to connect 2 IR sensor, that is IR transmitter and an IR receiver, to detect the presence of a cell phone. So what I will do is I will take a 2-pin patch card and connect a receiver to this. Make sure you connect the longer leg to the positive and shorter leg to the negative. So this is done. So take one more cable and connect your transmitter. Again, make sure the positive is connected to red and negative is connected to black. So this is done. So if you see in the box, I have made 3 holes over here, one over here, one over here, and the third one over here. So this is for the transmitter, receiver, and your red LED. So what I will do is, so let me put a receiver to this hand. So I will insert this wire over here and connect my receiver over here. So you can also see that I have made 2 holes here and here so that I can insert my receiver and transmitter. Okay, now I have inserted my receiver. So let me insert my transmitter. you can change the direction, you can connect receiver this side and transmit this side, so it doesn't harm too much. So let me connect my transmitter over here. So I have connected my sensors. Let me connect my LED. So I'm taking one more patch cord and connecting positive, that is the bigger leg, to red and the smaller leg to black. So let me connect this from behind. Okay, this is done. So I'll show you how to connect this to your B-box. Now I'll take this 2-pin connectors and connect this to A1 and B1. We know that the transmitter has to be connected to B1 and the receiver has to be connected to A1. So I'm connecting this red LED to B4 and negative. Make sure the red wire has to go to B4 and black wire has to go to negative. Fine, let me show you how to connect this now. So I will keep my B-box behind and this is my transmitter. I need to connect my transmitter to B-box, that is to pin V1. Positive of V1 should go to positive of transmitter, that is to the red wire. And when it comes to receiver, it has to be connected in reverse direction. So red should go to negative of A1 and black should come to positive of A1. So red is going towards, sorry, I need to connect this over top. Okay, so red is going to negative and black is coming to positive, fine. So I need to connect my red LED to B4. So I need to make sure this red wire goes to B4 and black wire goes to negative. Fine, this setup is done. So let me put this inside. And finally, what I need to do is I need to connect my both the batteries to a serial connector and connect the other end of the serial connector to power supply. As soon as I connect my power supply, you can see our red light over here, and make sure you switch on your power switch and your sensor switch. So let me keep this inside and turn this. So this is all what you need to construct your intelligent cell phone holder.
I'm going to show you how to program your B-box for this project. First, drag in the start and go to settings. In this project, you're going to use a pair of IR sensors. So you're going to connect your IR sensors to pin A1. So make A1 as input analog and save it. So once this is run, first we need to check out the sensor value. So you can upload your program now. So it will ask you to save your file. Please do save it. Sign from name. So now your program is getting uploaded to B-box. So now once this is done, go to B-profiler. Maximize the window and click on add to read A1. Once this is done, click on play button. Now you can see that the value, sensor value, is somewhere around 831, 832. Now I have not kept my B-box inside the mobile phone holder. Now let me put my mobile phone inside and check the value. So when I put the mobile phone, you can see the value drop down immediately to somewhere around 40. Now let me pull it back, it went to 380. So you can clearly see that when I put my mobile phone inside the pouch, the value is somewhere around 40, and when once I remove it, the value is 8, more than 800. So note down both of this value and close your profiler. Now, drag a decision and connect this to start. So select A1 in the input and select less than. And here you can type in value as 200. Once this is done, now drag an output and connect this to yes. If yes, so we'll make B4 as 1. Now I have connected my red LED to B4. That is, I have connected the positive of the LED to B4 and negative of that to negative in the B box. So let me copy this once again and paste this to Here, let me make B4 as 0. So this is all the program that what you need in order to build this project. So as per this, once you put your mobile phone inside your pouch or the holder, mobile phone holder, the LED light will be on. Once you remove it, the LED light will be off. So you can upload your program now.
Now I'm going to show you how this project works. You can clearly see there is no cell phone inside your holder and the red light is off. So let me put my cell phone inside this, and you can see as soon as I put my cell phone inside the holder, the red light is on. So this indicates that the cell phone is inside the holder. So once I take it, so the light goes off. So when I put it on, off, on, off. So this is how your project works.